Hello everyone, I'm Akash. In today's video, we will see a nice application of this beautiful result in a group theory. This result states that if the quotient group G by Z of G is cyclic, then G is abelian. So before going to the application, let's quickly see its proof. It will take just 2 to 3 minutes. Please don't skip the proof because proofs are very important part of mathematics. They tell us why the result is true. In fact, they deepen your understanding in solving complex problems in mathematics. So let's get started. We will use these two definitions in this proof. So let's recall these two definitions first. Center of group G. The center of group G is denoted by Z of G is a set of all those elements in a group G which commutes with every element of group G. We can easily prove that center of group G is a subgroup of group G. In fact, center is an abelian, that is commutative subgroup of group G. The quotient group, that is the factor group G by H, is a collection of all left coset of H in G. The quotient group G by H, that is the factor group G by H, is a collection of all left coset of H in G. It is a group under the operation of these cosets. This operation can be read as left coset of H in G containing x1 times left coset of H in G containing x2 is equals to left coset of H in G containing x1, x2. So we will use these two definitions in this proof. So let's see this proof. Let's assume that this quotient group G by Z of G is cyclic. Our aim is to show that G is abelian. Now, as this group is cyclic, so by definition of cyclic group, it must be generated by any one of its element. But element of this quotient group are cosets, and in particular, they are left coset of Z of G in G. So there must be some left coset of Z of G in G, which generates this whole group. Say this whole group is generated by this left coset. So there must be some X belongs to G such that this whole group is equal to the subgroup generated by this left coset. Now, let G be any arbitrary element of group G. Then the left coset of Z of G containing this G must belongs to this quotient group. We have just considered any arbitrary element of this quotient group. Okay. And as this quotient group is cyclic and generated by this left coset, so this left coset must be some power of this generator. So this left coset is equals to some power of this generator, say kth power for some k belongs to integers. Then by properties of cosets, this can be written as the left coset of Z of G in G containing x to the power k. And as here two left cosets are equal, so by these properties of coset, left coset of H in G containing A equals to the left coset of H in G containing B, if and only if B inverse A belongs to H. Okay. So B inverse A belongs to H. That is X to the power K inverse times G belongs to center of group G. Okay. As this product is an element of center of group G, so let's denote this product by Z. So there must exist some Z belongs to center of group G such that Z equals to this product. Now multiply both sides by X to the power K. So we get G equals to the X to the power K times Z for some Z belongs to center of group G and K belongs to integers. But G is an arbitrary element of group G. So this is true for all elements of group G. So every element of group G can be written in this way. So let A and B be any two elements of group G. Then A can be written in this form and B can also be written in this form. Say A equals to x to the power k1 times z1 and B equals to x to the power k2 times z2 for some z1 comma z2 belongs to center of group G and k1 comma k2 are integers. Then consider the product of these two elements AB. Clearly AB equals to x to the power k1 times z1 times x to the power k2 times z2. As Z1 is an element of center of group G, so by definition of center of group G, it commutes with every element of group G. So Z1 commutes with X to the power K2 also. So this can be written as x to the power k1 times x to the power k2 times z1 times z2. Okay, I have just shifted this. Okay, so x to the power k1 times x to the power k2 times z1 times z2, and this is nothing but equals to x to the power k1 plus k2 times z1 times z2. And as k1 and k2 are integers, and we know that integers are commutative with respect to addition, so k1 plus k2 is nothing but equals to k2 plus k1. So this is equals to x to the power k2 plus k1 times z1 times z2. This is nothing but x to the power k2 times x to the power k1 times z1 times z2. Again, as z2 is an element of center of group G, so this z2 commutes with this z1 also. This z2 commutes with this x to the power k1 also. So I shift this z2 to here. So we get x to the power k2 times z2 times x to the power k1 times z1. And this is nothing but b, and this is nothing but a. So we see that for arbitrary elements a comma b belongs to G, we have AB equals to BA. And this shows that G is abelian. So now let's see application of this beautiful result. A nice application of this result is, if G is a non-abelian group, then order of center of group G is less or equals to 1 by 4 times order of G. To see it, we will prove its contrapositive statement. So what will be its contrapositive statement? If order of center of group G is greater than 1 by 4 times order of G, then G is abelian. So if we prove this contrapositive statement, then this result will be proved. Okay, and these both statements are very useful in solving problems. Okay, so remember these both statements. So let's prove this contrapositive statement. Now, order of center of group G is greater than 1 by 4 times order of G. We have this, so we have assumed this, and clearly this imply, if we shift 4 here on left hand side, so we get 4 greater than order of G by center of group G. Okay, so we see that order of this quotient group G by center of group G is always less than 4. Okay, is always less than 4, that is, it is at most equals to 3. So this implies G by center of group G is cyclic, because we know that every group of order less or equals to 3 is cyclic. So G by Z of group G is cyclic in this case. And so by this result, this implies G is abelian. Okay, so by this result we get G is abelian. Thus we see that if G is non-abelian group, then order of center of group G is always less or equals to 1 by 4 times order of G. Or in other words, if order of center of group G is greater than 1 by 4 times order of G, then G is abelian. So this is a very nice application of this beautiful result. So if you found this video interesting and helpful, then please like and share this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.